Mariners for you.
I generally avoid expressing sympathy for inanimate objects on this show or really anywhere else, but it has been a particularly rough year for the shipping container. Do you remember this?
It's one of the world's most important shipping routes, and it's blocked. A giant container ship ran aground in the Suez Canal after losing power.
The 200,000-ton, 400-meter-long Ever Given, not Evergreen, Ever Given, that was blocked the Suez Canal for 6 days in March, closing off a waterway through which an average of 50 ships a day usually pass, supertankers, representing 12% of global trade. Hundreds of container ships waited anxiously as an army of machine operators and tugboats raced against time to free the ship, while others decided to take the long way around the Horn of Africa, adding weeks to their journeys and more than $26,000 a day in their fuel costs. 90% of the world's global trade is shipped by sea, with 70% in those massive container ships. And while the Ever Given was eventually freed, the pileup in the Suez last spring was really just a warning shot. Today, that traffic jam has gone global. The trouble started with the pandemic, when China sent huge amounts of protective gear to regions like West Africa and South Asia. And countries there had little reason to send product back to China. So as these
don't forget to subscribe
up,
the Mariners for You channel Chinese and click on bell icon to get notification.
To wealthier Western countries where demand was skyrocketing. Before the pandemic, sending a container from Shanghai to Los Angeles cost around $2,000. By early 2021, 1 year later, the same trip could run you upwards of $25,000. At the same time, container ships in North American and European ports overwhelmed docks that were already understaffed because of pandemic quarantines and the long-standing lack of skilled labor, like crane operators. In the ports of Los Angeles and Long Beach, California, some of the biggest in the U.S., they handle roughly 40% of all inbound containers in the United States. Dozens of ships were just sitting there, forced to anchor out in the ocean for days before they could unload.
Off the coast of Los Angeles, container ships, mostly from Asia, stretching across the horizon.
And so you see a cascading effect as companies responded to the shipping shortages by ordering more goods, which added in turn to shipping strains and filled up warehouses. Shipping containers in turn became storage areas, piling up in ports and clogging up trade. And truck drivers and rail operators nationwide are understaffed and overworked. Will the holiday rush be the straw that breaks the container's back? The verdict remains out. But in the meantime, I don't know, maybe we should buy local.
For more video about container terminals and container ships, subscribe the Mariners for You YouTube channel. Thank for watching Mariners for You. See you soon.